When two products come together with new and unique capabilities, customers benefit from the better together value that is created. Dell VxRail and Dell PowerStore have done just this with the new Dynamic AppsON Lifecycle Management of PowerStore Arrays from the VxRail Manager UI and workflows. Dynamic AppsON is a Dell-exclusive capability between VxRail and PowerStore. In this demo, we'll show how to view the PowerStore details directly from the VSI plugin and VxRail Manager in vCenter, followed by the upgrade using Dynamic AppsON. First, we'll navigate to the Dell VSI plugin and click on Storage Systems. Then, expand the PowerStore appliance and note that the software version is 3.0. Next, we'll navigate to the vCenter inventory page and click the VxRail cluster. We can see that there is a VxRail cluster tag called Dynamic Node, which indicates this is a Dynamic Node cluster. Then, select Configure System. We can see that the VxRail is running 7.0.450 code. We can also see the external storage details listed here. It shows that primary storage is true, external storage product is PowerStore, and the external storage version is 3.0. Finally, we'll open PowerStore Manager and navigate to Settings, Upgrades. On this page, we can confirm that the PowerStore software version is indeed 3.0. Now we'll show the PowerStore OS upgrade procedure using the Dynamic AppsON Lifecycle Manager. The LCM allows you to complete the entire PowerStore OS upgrade process directly from within vCenter, without needing to launch any additional interfaces. In this demo, we'll upgrade the PowerStore cluster from PowerStore OS 3.0 to 3.2. First, we'll navigate to the VxRail Dynamic Nodes cluster, Configure tab, and the Updates page under the VxRail section. Then, we'll click Local Updates and choose PowerStore Updates. As you can see, the PowerStore OS Lifecycle Management functionality is integrated right next to where you would do a VxRail update. Click Select on PowerStore Updates. Choose the PowerStore OS upgrade file. Click Upload and enter the PowerStore credentials. This uploads the upgrade file to the PowerStore cluster, so it may take a few minutes to complete. A progress bar tracks the file upload status. For demo purposes, we'll speed this up. When the file upload completes, click Next to continue. The next step is to perform a pre-check on the PowerStore cluster. This is a PowerStore pre-upgrade health check, or PUHC, that can be initiated prior to the actual upgrade to check for any potential issues. This helps the administrator detect and remedy issues prior to the actual upgrade process. No changes are made to the system during the pre-upgrade health check. Click the pre-check button and then click Run Pre-check to start the health check. The progress bar shows the status of the pre-check. This takes a few minutes to complete. When complete, any warnings or failures that were discovered during the pre-check are displayed. You can bypass any warnings because they do not impact the upgrade. However, failures will impact the upgrade, so they must be remedied before the upgrade can proceed. For demo purposes, we intentionally did not enable Support Assist so that a warning is generated. This warning indicates that Remote Access and Connect Home are not enabled on the cluster. Because this is just a warning and is expected, we can proceed with the upgrade. When the pre-check completes, click Next to continue. The last step is to initiate the upgrade on the PowerStore cluster by clicking Update, and to confirm by clicking Update. The progress bar shows the status of the upgrade. As with all PowerStore upgrades, the operation is non-disruptive and all workloads continue to run throughout the upgrade process. When the upgrade completes, click Finish to complete the upgrade and refresh the screen. When we navigate to the VxRail system page, we can see here that the external storage version is now 3.2. If we navigate to VSI, we can see that the same 3.2 version is updated in the VSI plugin. Finally, if we open PowerStore Manager, we can confirm that the software version is 3.2. In the Recent Activities pane, we can see that the upload package, pre-upgrade health check, and upgrade jobs were completed successfully. The warnings displayed here were caused by Support Assist being disabled. As shown in this video, the Lifecycle Management functionality provides the ability to report the PowerStore OS code and orchestrate upgrades directly from the VxRail Manager UI. A virtualization and storage administrator doesn't have to leave the vCenter UI to have consistent and common management of VxRail and PowerStore. The integration between VxRail, PowerStore, and the VSI plugin enables consistent workflows and visibility between storage and compute. Better together through Dynamic AppsON, brought to you by Dell VxRail and Dell PowerStore. Thanks for watching.